Hello friends, welcome back to Bio Vidyalaya. I hope you all are doing very well. Here in this video, we are going to discuss about one of the important topics from genetics, that is complementation test. You may get a part C 4-mark question from this concept. At the end of this video, we will discuss one CSIR NET previous year question. So before going to begin, if you are new to my channel or if you have not subscribed this channel yet, then please subscribe now and also enable the bell icon so you will get notification when I upload new videos. So let's start. I am trying to explain this concept as simple as possible. Please try to watch this video till the end. Okay. So, what is meant by complementation test? Complementation test, also called cis-trans test in genetics, tests for determining whether two mutations associated with a specific phenotype represent two different forms of the same genes, that means alleles, or are variations of two different genes. That means in complementation test, we are testing whether the mutation is present in the same gene or in different gene. Okay. If you have two mutants and that have same phenotype, then how you will find whether this mutation are in same gene or in different gene? For that purpose only we are using complementation test. So in complementation test, we are testing whether this mutation are present in same gene or in different gene. Okay. The test is simple. Two mutants are crossed and F1 is analyzed. Here in this complementation test, two mutants are crossed and after that we will get F1 progeny and we are analyzing F1 progeny. If F1 does not express wild type phenotype but rather a mutant phenotype, we conclude that both the mutation occur in same gene. That means that mutation is non-complement. This is non-complementation. And if we are getting a wild type phenotype rather than mutant, we are getting wild type rather than mutant, we can say that this mutation are present in different gene and they are complement to each other. Okay. I will explain it with one example. For example, a mutant phenotype, white eye color in Drosophila. Okay. So here we are mating two strains of mutant phenotypes, white eye color Drosophila. This is also white eye. This is a mutant. Both are mutant. Here we are checking whether this mutation is present in same gene or different gene. Okay. So in F1 progeny we will get. Okay. This is the F1 progeny. Okay. And this is a red eye and this red eye is the wild type. Okay, so mating two organisms with similar mutant phenotype can lead to wild type offspring and That is called genetic complementation. If we are getting wild type after the mating with two similar mutant phenotype, then we can say that this is genetic complementation. Okay, genetic complementation. So here this capital A and capital B dominant alleles, they are working protein, and this genes or this alleles, this dominant alleles are required for the synthesis of a red eye color pigment. But this recessive alleles A and B are malfunctioning. Okay, so both dominant A and B are required for the synthesis of red eye pigment. That's why here we are getting wild type. Okay, so here we are getting wild type phenotype. So we can conclude that this mutation are present in different gene. So we can say that this mutation is present in different gene A and B. Okay. So if mutation is present in different gene, like this, we can say that there is complementation. If mutation are present in same gene, if mutation, this dot is representing mutation, if mutation is present in same gene, there is no complementation. This you have to remember. If complementation occurs, mutation are in two different genes. Okay. And a group of mutant which do not complement each other belonging to single complementation group. A group of mutant which do not complement each other belong to single complementation group. Okay. Next. So here you can see that these are the two mutants. This is one mutant and this is another mutant. We are mating them and we are getting a wild type phenotype. If we are getting a wild type phenotype, then we can say that this mutation is present in two different genes and they are complementation, that is complement to each other. There is complementation. Okay. If this mutation that is present in same gene, then we will get a mutant phenotype in F1. We will get a mutant F1 progeny. Then we can say that this mutation are present in same gene and there is no complementation, non-complementation. Okay, so let's see one question. This is the question from CSIRnet June 2013. Question is, given below is the result of a complementation test for 6 independent mutation 1 to 6. Plus represents complementation and 0 represents non-complementation. Based on the above, which one of the following conclusion is correct? The mutation can be ordered in a single cystone as 1, 3, 5, 2, 4, 6. Option B, all mutations belong to single cistron, but their order cannot be determined. Option C, there are three cistron, mutation 1, 3, 6 represent one cistron, 4 and 5 represent the second cistron, and 2 represent the third cistron. Option B, there are three linkage groups, mutation 1, 3 and 6 represent linkage group A, 4 and 5 represent linkage group B, and 6 represent linkage group C. So here, complementation test for 6 independent mutation 1, 2, 6 are given, and here plus represent complementation. That means we are getting wild type phenotype in F1. And mutation is present in different gene. And here 0 represent non-complementation. That means this mutation is present in same gene and we are getting mutant phenotype in F1 progeny. Okay. So here a group of mutant which do not complement to each other belonging to single complementation group. A group of mutant which do not complement to each other belong to single complementation group, that means single cistron or one cistron. So here mutant 1 that is mating with 3 and here we are getting non-complementation. Here we are getting non-complementation. So we can say that 1 and 3 are in one complementation group. Next, here also we are getting non-complementation. After mating with mutant 1 and 6, we are getting non-complementation. So we can write 1 and 6 is also in one complementation group or single cistron. Let's see this 3 and 6 are in same complementation group or different. Yes, here also we are getting non-complementation. So we can say that 1, 3, 6 are in one complementation. 1, 3 and 6 are in one complementation group or one cistron. Next, 2. We can write 2 as separate because there is no non-complementation. Okay. Here, 4. Here we can say that there is one non-complementation. So we can say that 4 and 5 in another complementation group. Okay. So this is one complementation group. This is the second complementation group. And 2 alone is another complementation group. Okay. So let's come to the options. Based on the above, which one of the following conclusion is correct? Options. Option A, the mutation can be ordered in a single cistron as 1, 3, 5, 2, 4, 6. No, we got 3 complementation group or 3 cistron. So this is not correct. Option A is incorrect. Next, option B, all mutation belong to single cistron but their order cannot be determined. This is also not correct. We got three cistern, that's why this option B is also incorrect. Next option, option C, there are three cistern, that is correct. Mutation 1, 3 and 6 represent one cistern, that is also correct. 4, 5 represent second cistern, that is correct. And 2 represent third cistern, that is also correct. So the option C is correct. Next option D, there are three linkage tube. Mutation 1, 3 and 6 represents linkage group A. 4 and 5 represent linkage group B and 6 represent linkage group C. We all know that linkage group means a group of genes in a chromosome that tends to be inherited as a unit. So this is also not correct. So the correct answer is option C. There are three cisterns. Mutation 1, 3 and 6 represent one cistern. 4 and 5 represent the second cistern and 2 represent the third cistern. Okay, I think this is clear for you. Here I am winding up this video. If you like this video and find it helpful, please click the like button, share with your friends and subscribe this channel to get more videos like this. Keep learning. Thank you.